So in today's video, I thought I'd have a go at repairing my power window switch and the surround. The surround breaks really easily along those like lines that you see, those kind of, you know, struts at the side where the switch goes through for the door lock, and it's easily broken. Usually there's a crack on one of them. This one broke in two when I tried to fix one side of it. So I tried to epoxy it one time in the past, as you can see in the picture here, but it wasn't very successful and broke. So in this video, I'm going to sort of repair it, hopefully, and show you what I did. Now, it's not a perfect job, but I think it's good enough, considering the high price of these things now. To get one, that's probably £100 plus. I think I saw one on eBay at $199 plus 50 postage, which is like off the scale.
So this is the type of thing I've come up with. This is just kind of tacked into place with a wee bit of super glue, and it overlays, it gives it like a sort of lip for this bit to sit on. Now, it's not glued or anything, but it seems to fit reasonably well and straight. So it gives it a bit of a brace, a bit of support, so that it shouldn't just crack and fall apart again. It's not the prettiest, and I'm not too sure this goes on the door. This kind of bites into the fabric on the door. So I hope this doesn't sit too proud, but I'll cross that bridge when I come to it. And I might be able to sort of use the Dremel and just smooth this down once it's secure. I've let that dry bit at the back there, and I bolted this down to the board just to give it a bit of pressure here. And also put a wee bit of epoxy behind it just to hold it. It's not perfect. You can see there's a bit of a gap here, and it's a bit rough here. It's not, you know, brilliant, but it's certainly not terrible, and it's a lot better than having to spend £150 on a new one of these until I can get a new one at a reasonable price, if I ever can. So I hope to use a little bit of filler, maybe something like this, which is like a modeler's filler, and just put this in here and then maybe respray this. Okay, so what I've done is use a little bit of modeler filler and just filled in the gap here. And it's not brilliant, you can still feel a little bit of a lip when you go over it, but it's not terrible. You know, so I'm going to do the same to the other side. Just here, I'm just using a screwdriver. It's like a wee putty knife. I suppose you could just use your finger, to be honest. Try and get it in there. I just don't want to spread it too much because it's like a cracked finish, and I don't want it sort of, you know, like being in all those wee cracks, although you can wipe it out quite easily. So that's the final job there. So I'm just giving this a bit of a once over with a foamy rag here, or a bit of detergent, just to clean off any residue before I spray it. I may drop this switch out rather than trying to mask it off, because it's then going to be easier. Although I've got this bulge at the back, which I showed you earlier, where the screw was going through, so I need to make a wee bit of a, you know, a wedge for that screw. So I'm reasonably happy. That one's a bit rough, so I'm going to just maybe refill that. It'll just, you know, I don't want to make it too fillerish, because then it's going to look different in this crackle here. So don't worry to sand it, or, you know, try and fill it or what. If I sanded it again, it'll look too smooth. So I'm just going to try and take the lip off a bit.
Okay, so that's it, pretty much finished. It's still a little bit rough. I can feel it, you know, here with my nail, so the spray can will pick it up. I don't know whether to try maybe a wee bit more filler in it, or just leave it as is. I did try paint that I'm going to be using on the back, and it seemed to be not too bad. That's this paint, which is an old tin of Halfords black bumper paint. Okay, so I've just finished spraying this, and I just thought I'd show you the back of it with these kind of supports. Now, it's a lot stronger. It was not pretty, but, you know, solid. Now, this side of it, not so happy about. You can still see the line here, which I thought, you know, so the modelers amongst you will go like, what the, you know, you could have done a better job than that, and probably could. I just don't really have the kit and know what I'm doing to do this properly. Plus, when it's on the car, it's going to look kind of okay, you know, but yeah, could be better, to be honest. But the spray came out nicely, you know, so that plastic spray does a good job. So here we have the switch on the door, and I think it's not a bad job. You can still see the lines, so I'm a wee bit disappointed about that, but I'm not a modeler, and I think it's okay given the tools I had and the time I wanted to put into it. So it looks a lot better and saves me spending 150 big ones on a new piece of plastic, which by anybody's standard is a bit much. So thanks for stopping by, and hopefully we'll do some more CRX videos in the future. Cheers.